Good morning and welcome to
Ned's Adventures.
Where are we at today, Val?
It is day two of the birthday weekend extravaganza, and it's stop number three, another old favorite. Well, I will say, I started with my favorite gas station today. We're going to my favorite grocery store. We are at Jungle Jim's in Fairfield. We're going to check some stuff out, see what they have. We'll probably buy some food. We may not eat it on camera this time, but we'll kind of put up words maybe if it's good or not. We'll see. We'll see what we do and how it goes. Let's go check it out.
All right, let's go. Definitely need one of these. Going in the giraffe entrance.
Okay, so in case you're not aware, Jungle Jim's isn't just a grocery store. It's an international market, but it's also all kinds of stuff, not just food.
For instance, Jungle Jim's toys and collectibles. Uh-oh, Val found something.
It's a cute little Slytherin backpack.
She's a Harry Potter fan. Got their own little Funko Pop section. All kinds of stuff. You want an Ohio cutting board?
It's really cool. Now we're in cookware, in case you wonder. We are here. We live here. Fun.
What'd you find?
These molds. You can make like a llama egg or pancake or unicorn. Aren't they cute? They're so cute.
They have a whole pet section here at Jungle Jim's. Jungle pets. We can get toys and treats and stuff like that. We don't have any pets, so we're not going to be going through that section.
There's so much weird stuff. Do you need a hot dog holder? You could have a dinosaur, a weenie-saurus, or a tacosaurus rex to hold your taco. Ooh, or a nachos. Ooh, I like this one. Chips and salsa are one of my favorites. Nachosaurus, your chips, and then you just dip. How perfect.
You want sushi? They got it here at Jungle Jim's.
Looks like they're making it fresh.
Yeah, I believe they are. This is the original part of the Jungle Jim's building in 1974. Original Jungle Jim's building, 1974. Pretty cool.
So, Jungle Jim's does have a huge, like, regular American grocery store section. That's kind of where we are now. You'll see it says American groceries. When we get into the international part, you'll see, like, each country has its own section. So, this is the America section.
So, these are the restrooms here at Jungle Jim's. First appearance, you think it's a Johnny on the spot. So, I'm like, no, I'm not going to use this restroom. There's no way. And then I opened the door. It's a regular, really nice restroom in there. I was totally fooled.
I come up and Ed's like standing there like, what do I do? I had used the restroom here before. Apparently he had not.
Health food? That's no fun.
No, we've done that a few times and we just spend money on food that doesn't taste very good.
All right, we have made our way back to the international food section. Valerie's getting excited.
Do we want to do fun pop this time?
Sure.
Let's go.
Not necessarily international pop, but fun pop, as Valerie would call it.
So it's really cool. They have all these bottles of pop, and you pick your pack. You can pull out like a little container. So this one's got four bottles, so I can pick any four bottles, mix and match, and that's what I pay for.
We'll see what she gets.
Okay, so since there's four choices, we decided Ed gets one pick and I get three, because that's fair.
So I saw this blue cream soda, but I'm thinking how good could that actually be? So I'm going to go with something I actually like. I like Valerie, who's a little bit different than that. She may take chances and pick something that she don't like.
It's true.
But I know for sure that I'm going to like this. So that's what I'm going to get.
Okay, Val, what'd you get?
So Ed's choice was very boring root beer. So I had to spice it up a little bit. I went with chocolate soda. You see that?
Yep.
Chocolate soda with peanut butter and cocoa. Probably disgusting, but we're going to try it. I went with the fun Buckeye State Scarlet soda. I don't know what it tastes like. I'm going to guess like a strawberry-ish. We'll find out. Ed's rushing me along. I love the pop aisle. And then the best one, I found birthday cake because it's my birthday weekend. They also had key lime pie and carrot cake and coffee cake. Pretty amazing.
Okay, now we are finally in the international section. Let's see what Valerie decides to buy.
I'm going to try and not buy something from every single country like we tend to do. Maybe just a few select things that catch my eye. We're in Ireland right now. Holland will be next. Let's see what they have. Are Mentos from Holland? We're in the Holland aisle, I'm pretty sure. And they have a whole Mentos display. I do enjoy a Mento. Didn't know they were from Holland. They have Holland. Clearly it's from Holland. But we have little windmills. We have tulips. Oh, we have more tulips. They're so cute. All right, I found something I wanted. Ireland didn't have anything. Holland doesn't have much. But I am gonna get some stroop waffles. They are delicious. You lay it over your coffee cup and it kind of gets a little soft. Mm.
We are now in Germany and Valerie has spotted something.
I wish we were in Germany. I wanna go to Germany someday. So I have a Instagram friend that lives in Germany and she's always talking about marzipan. Like that's a big treat there. So I think we're gonna get some marzipan to try.
We are still in Germany and I'm gonna get this Oreo sandwich chocolate candy. Oh yeah. I'm not gonna get any, but this chocolate is the best chocolate in the world, in my opinion. This person evidently talks. But not right now.
So now we're in like the Mexico general Hispanic section. I've got it set up as this big like marketplace with all these pinatas. It's really pretty. Last time we got these guava wafers. They were pretty good.
This time I'm getting the strawberry wafers.
And because I like to be different, we're getting the pineapple wafers as well. Ed has decided he wants to try some chips from the Hispanic section. I think we're gonna go with these.
Ugh. Got them. Yuca?
I think it's yucca. I'm saying yucca. Cassava chips? No idea what that is or what that means, but sounds delicious.
We'll see. They have a whole hot sauce section here at Jungle Jim's. And the fire truck display hanging over all of it. That's pretty cool. Any kind of hot sauce you could think of, Jungle Jim's has it. We are now in Korea and I spotted these honey butter almonds. It's going in the cart.
Are you sure you don't want seaweed flavor?
I'm positive. Val.
Yeah.
It looks like from the looks of it in our cart, we're going to be focused on snacks.
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of where we tend to go. I don't want to have to actually cook something. So we like the snacks.
What are you getting, Val?
All right, we're in the Philippine section, and I'm going to get these potato fries. Baked, not fried. Okay, we're in the Japanese section, and I love when we find different flavors of Kit Kats. Although some are obvious, like, okay, that's an orange. I don't know what this green one is. Maybe matcha? Is that a thing? Okay, is this onion? No, it's like a nut, right? Like a hazelnut. We're going hazelnut.
But the one she's going to choose is...
I'm going to go with the green. We're going to be adventurous and get the one I don't know what it is. Because that just feels right.
All right, put it in the cart. Robin Hood up here. He was actually talking a few seconds ago.
All right, so we think we're in the Malaysia section. We're gonna get these banana cream biscuits. We're literally just walking the aisles and like grabbing what catches our eye. And just caught our eye.
We are in the Great Britain section. I'm going to get some of this stuff. Strawberry jam, maybe?
Yeah, I don't know. Preserves. It's jam.
I'm going to try it out. What you got?
I have no idea what it is, but it's called a Curly Whirly. How could I not get it? From Great Britain.
What you got?
All right, we're going to try these chili chaka. They were just on an end cap. We're kind of in Nepal. They might be Indian. Some of it's a little hard to tell. It's kind of in between sections, but these look interesting, so we're going to try them.
So we're in China, and you love all the fun flavors.
I love. So we have Lay's chips. It's just like the Kit Kats. I have no idea what any of them are. Like, what is that?
You know, they have tons of flavors, as you can see.
Oh, here's tomato.
We'll see what Val comes up with.
And it's in English. Yay. Mexican chicken tomato flavor. At least we would know what it was. American classic flavor. Oh, okay. Some of them have English. This one does not have English. Oh, I feel like that's like a... Is that seaweed? Oh, seaweed flavor. Reading is fundamental. This one does not have English. I don't know. Cucumber flavor.
I love cucumbers.
I know. You want to get cucumber flavor?
Sure, let's get cucumber.
Oh my gosh. Italian red meat flavor. Like spaghetti sauce, potato chips. All right, we'll get cucumber. We have been through every aisle in the international market now. We're tired. Here's our cart. We did shop the American groceries a little bit for a couple things we needed. That's up here. And then everything international is down there. Many, many countries.
Many, many things to try.
Yay!
All right, we are now heading to the checkout section. Time to check out.
Let's go.
It's all our goodies. Are you ready?
Let's go. So I convinced Ed to try one snack real quick. The Curly Whirly. It's chocolate. Ooh. It's caramel. That's not what I expected. I don't like Curly Whirly. It's hard.
Alrighty then.
Well, hopefully the other treats we got were better than that Curly Whirly, which actually, strangely enough, you guys already know if we like them or not, but we haven't actually eaten them yet. Another fun trip to Jungle Gyms. Right. I do love it. It's very big. Like, we showed a tiny part of the store, I feel like. It's just gigantic. But yeah, it was super fun.
And as always, thanks for watching our videos, and we'll see you on the next adventure.
Bye.